portion of your workout. So this is designed to be something that can complement any workout that you do, not just these barre workouts. You can also just do this on its own as a kind of mini yoga practice for your day. These are just gentle stretches that just feel good when you wake up in the morning or in the evening when you're ready to kind of relax and put the body to rest. So we're going to start in a child's pose. Big toes together, knees apart, and just sit back towards your heels and walk your hands out in front. Let your forehead relax into the mat and breathe deeply here. Inhaling through the nose, and let's exhale through the nose. Inhale and exhale. Let's walk our hands over to the right side, maybe placing your left hand on top of the right, reaching through that left side. Inhale and exhale. Walk over to the other side, left side. Right hand on top of the left, reaching long. And coming back to the center. Up onto all fours. Shoulders just over the wrists. We are going to extend our left leg back. Toes on the mat and push through that back heel. Towards, like you're trying to push it towards the mat. It's obviously not going to go there, but this is stretching out the hamstring, stretching out the calf, especially. And if you've done the barre leg workout, you might need this stretch. Holding and breathing in and out. Switching sides, left leg back. Push the heel back. And breathe. Breathing in and out. And knee back on the mat. Back to our tabletop, which in this case is our flat back. Let's do a little cat and cow. We're going to inhale, lift and drop the belly towards the mat, push the hips up, look up, exhale, round into your cat, dropping the head, pulling the belly button up, and again, inhale, lift the heart, and exhale, round, and if you want to add that scooping that sometimes, you know, we like to do, it feels good. Go ahead, inhale, bend the elbows and chest towards the mat, and then lift, more exaggerated cow. And then lower and lift the back, lift that belly button up into your cat. And again, inhale, scoop and lift. And exhale. Round up into cat. And come back to a flat back. Let's sit back onto our heels. I know my hair is a mess here. This is what happens, right? Especially at the end of a workout. Sit back on your heels. You can stay here. If this feels like a stretch for you, especially your knees are talking to you, then stay here and you can open up the chest. Here, pull the shoulders back and open. In fact, we can all just do this right now. This feels much, then go ahead and lower the feet, the tops of the feet back down. And round. And release. Shake out the feet. Let's take a little stretch here for the forearms and the wrists. You're going to turn your fingers to point towards you. Forearms facing the front of the room or wherever you are, and push into the palms and slowly kind of lean back. So I'm moving my hips a little bit back to feel that stretch. Ooh, and it's a big stretch. It's a little movement, huge stretch for the wrists and forearms. Only go as far as feels like a good stretch to you. Be gentle here. Push into the fingers. And release and turn palms back around. Maybe rotate. Sit back now towards your child's pose, but walk your hands out in front for puppy stretch, puppy pose. Chest down towards the mat, hips are lifted, head drops. Walk those hands even more out in front. And feel the stretch through the shoulders. Through the chest. Breathe, inhaling. And exhale. Walk the hands back in. Let's take our eye of the needle stretch. Right arm threading underneath left. Gently placing that right cheek down. Not worrying about the hips coming down, just focus on pushing the shoulder into the mat. If it feels good to you to add a twist, maybe extending through the top arm. It is optional. Breathing, inhale and exhale. These stretches are especially good after you do the upper body workout. And bring that hand back down. Switch sides. Left arm underneath right. Left cheek down. Gently push the shoulder. Maybe extend your top arm. And twist. And release. Coming back to the center. And we're going to transition onto our back. So cross at the ankle, if this works for you, and see if you can roll back over your shins. Feet out in front. And let's grab under the thighs. Roll safely back down to the mat. Feet flat on the mat. Let's go through some now lower body focus stretches. Hugging right knee into the chest. Extend your left leg long. Pull. And now walk your hands up that right leg. Feel free to hold these stretches for as long as you like. Holding the highest point you can reach on the leg. And then pointing and flexing the foot. Rotate the ankle. And you can probably hear the creaks and the cracks that I always have in my ankles and my feet. All right, we're going to take that leg with the opposite hand, and we're going to pull it across the body. You want to keep both shoulders down as you do this. We're not trying to entirely twist the body. We're focusing on the glutes now, stretching. You can also have that knee bent. In fact, if you bend it, you might be able to pull it a little further across. And as you press gently into that knee, you feel it more in the glutes. That feels wonderful. I've got my right hand outstretched at shoulder height to keep the shoulders down. Let's bring it back and let's take a supine pigeon, or a figure four stretch as it's sometimes called. So bring your left foot to the mat, place that right ankle just above the left knee, and reach to grab under the left thigh and pull towards you. As you flex the foot, this right foot helping to stretch the hip a little more. You can also, if you're quite flexible, and sometimes you don't feel this a lot, you can maybe extend your left leg, grab behind the calf, and maybe even pull towards you. Bring that right foot closer to the groin, higher up on the leg, and then pull again. Lots of different ways you can cater these stretches to help you feel it best. All right, let's bring it back down to the mat. And let's do the other side. Left knee into the chest, right leg long. Hug tightly. And walk the hands up the leg. However high you can reach, and pull gently. And begin to point and flex. And rotate the ankle. This is a good stretch if you're working on splits. I would be the first to say that I am not good at it. I can barely do a split this way. I cannot do one the other way, or whatever that's called. But this is one way that helps me work my way towards that. I'm a little out of practice. But if that's something that you're thinking about or working on, then this is a good stretch. I mean, you have all this time, right, at home, so why not try and work on trying to get to two splits? Okay, let's take that leg across the body. The left arm out to the side, anchor that shoulder down. And then maybe, like we did on the other side, maybe bend that knee and pull. You gently press the knee. I say gently press because we don't ever want to press hard into the joint. And that feels so good. And then come back. And take your figure four stretch, your pigeon stretch. Take that left ankle just above the right knee and reach under your right thigh, pull towards you, flex that left foot. And this also feels really good. The equivalent of our standing pigeon that we do, just taking out the balance. If you did on the other side, go ahead and reach behind that right calf and maybe pull a little deeper. Might find one side feels more flexible than the other. So we're getting also hip opener and hamstring stretch this way in one. And go ahead and release. We're going to start to roll ourselves back up. So bring the knees into the chest, both of them, give them a hug, little rock side to side. Even this is I don't know if you call it a stretch, but this is a release for your lower back. So even these little rocks and holds that we do, they are not just filler. These are also important for releasing areas that we've worked. Grab under the thighs and roll yourself back up to sitting. And I think we ended last time with this, but going to do it again hold. Legs in front, sitting into a staff pose here, which is rolling the shoulders back, staying tall. Let's take a big breath. Inhale. Reach and stay long here as you exhale. And you hinge for as long as you can, keeping it straight. And eventually release. Hands to the legs, hands to the feet, maybe peace fingers to the big toes. Looking ahead first, let's lift the heart. Inhale. And then exhale. Sink again. Inhale, lift. And exhale, fold. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale and hold here, and maybe now drop the head to where it wants to go. Breathe. Slowly roll back up. Come to mermaid on one side. I'm going to stack my feet on the right side, stacking or sitting on my left hip, and taking now the hand closest to that hip I'm sitting on. Inhale, lifting. And exhale, reach over and feel as graceful as a mermaid. Watch this opposite shoulder that it's not doing this. Just drop it down. I just caught my shoulder starting to do that. So release down. Oh, good stretch. And we float to the other side. Inhale and exhale, bring that other arm. And if you like, staying here or maybe dropping to your forearm and reaching even longer. Good side body stretch. And then next inhale, lift and release as you exhale and switch to your other side. Feet stacked. Let's take now that right arm. Inhale, lift, and exhale, reach over. When we do these reaches, important to really actively reach through the arm and the side body, all up and down here to maximize the stretch. Think of your fingers as propelling that arm up and over. Inhale, and exhale. Other side and reach. Enjoy these final stretches. So good. And inhale, rise and release. Let's come to a comfortable seated position. Give yourself a couple of twists here. We're going to inhale together, arms up. And then exhale, let's twist to the right. Left hand to right knee. Look back over the shoulder. Shoulders pulling down, spine tall. Inhale as we twist back to the center, lifting the arms. Exhale, other side, twist, and look back. And inhale, come back to the center, and let it go. And then take one more big breath with me. Inhale. And you're done with your stretch. And you're done, hopefully, with thank you guys for watching these videos. I really miss you all so much. So making these just makes me feel closer to you, and I just imagine you all on the other side. Please send me some photos of you doing these workouts. I would love that. It would just absolutely make my day. And please let me know if there's something you want to see more of. I'll try my best. I can't promise when I'm going to make videos, but I'll try my best to keep putting some little things out there like this. Love you all. Stay safe and healthy.